Welcome to Puka Art. My name is Mbeng Puka. I'm an artist, painter, and sculptor. And I'm going to be presenting the Queen Reign. This painting is all on canvas. It's approximately 170 by 2 meters. This painting has been done during the 2012 great year, was the year of the Olympic. And it was the year of the Diamond Jubilee. So it was very great to be in Great Britain in that time. Now, this painting is a prophetic painting. Prophetic painting, why? Because of the content. The painting is talking about time. 2012, time. Diamond Jubilee, time. It come in 60 years of rain, and only two queens has achieved that longevity onto the crown: Queen Victoria and now Queen Elizabeth. But the prophecy at this time is not like the prophecy in the beginning of the reign. The prophecy at this time is the end of the reign, the end of the glory. Today is the last Sunday of October. There are two dates in March and in October. People are changing the time. So this morning, the clock went backward for an hour, and it's happening every last Sunday of October every year. In fact, you may think they are in control of the time, but there is something above us that is the time. Okay, let's look into the painting. There is a song about the British pride that is always subject of rejoicement and during the proms. Reign Britannia, never slave again, Reign Britannia. But this song is always, it's something that is amazing. Why? Because it's the slave who are singing, never be slave again. Because the population is made of slaves. They are the ones who are working throughout history from the beginning. When a human is not a human anymore, it's subject of another one. So if you have somebody in front of you and you are the population, you are a slave. A slave work for the master. That's the definition of slavery. And our whole world is subject of slavery. We work for billionaires, we work for other people. So singing that we will never be slave again is a matter of philosophy. Now, let's go back to the painting. Here is all the population, the millions of people who are worshipping the Queen. In the year of Jubilee, I don't know how many million people turned that day, but the entire country was rejoicing of the greatness of the Queen. 60 years of reign is not one day. she has been witness of so many downfall of government, rise of power, and all sorts of things, World War I, World War II. It's a great history that need to be memorized into this kind of masterpiece. Her reign has been so successful and so powerful because it's not only the population in the United Kingdom who is worshiping the Queen. She's Queen in Canada, she's Queen in Australia, she's Queen she used to be Queen in Barbados. I think Barbados was trying to remove that title. In so many countries, it's a sign of a great power because the United Kingdom used to colonize America. So the Queen of England was also Queen of America. So the power was so great that the song "Will Never Be Slave Again" was matching the time everything was high. Can you imagine a small country, a small island, colonizing and stepping in more than half of the world country? Because when the United Kingdom took all over the world, it was so powerful that the pride was as high as the power. In Africa, you find Lake Victoria, you find Victoria, Victoria, Victoria everywhere, trees, Victoria, road, Victoria, most of the places. This phone box, no, this is the phone box here, it's written 2012 Queen Elizabeth Diamond Jubilee. This is a letter box. Those two things, including the bus, have a huge reputation all over the world. And in so many countries, you find the sign of the reign of the British. The languages all over the world. But there is something that makes the differences. The Queen, she's still very strong with all her power. But the kingdom has lost all its power. The Queen, she has her power, but the kingdom has lost all its power. And the last knock out came with Brexit. Brexit is the turning point of the inner trouble the kingdom is going through. Okay. This is the time for those who have difficulty acknowledging the sign of power. The sign of power in our world come with a stick, and let me take this just to show. Okay, I'll put one here. A stick and a globe. Everywhere people are in power, they use these two things to show the superiority above order. The stick and the globe. The globe is the land, the ground. The stick is the authority. So, when you look here, you will find out that if you see the picture of a crown, then you will see the stick, and you also see this globe. This globe, and on top of the globe is the power. So they always give the stick and the power for the domination. So here, through time, because in this painting, before we look into the explanation of the painting, is I'm going to show the spirit behind the picture. Here is the crown. It's the crown. So the queen, she's looking at her glory. The glory, you can see the big bang. I wanted to say the big bang, but it's the same thing. It's where those things started. Big bang, big bang. So you can see here the palaces. This is the cathedral, and here is the shard. In that time, the shard was the taller building in London. And we go to Cucumber, and more buildings have been growing up since. Here is the cross. The cross has a very big signification in the history of the United Kingdom, because they split from Rome, and the queen, she's the head of the church. She's the head of the church in the country. So her faith in God is has the faith of the Pope when it comes to the Catholic religion. So all the power are centralized into one person. So this is her crown, mostly made of diamond. And she's looking at her greatness. And here is the queen herself with her diamond jubilee Olympic game crown, seeing her glory from heaven to earth. Because having your face on top of the money is the glorious of the glorious state any human can have on earth. It cannot get higher than that. So into the globe, we see the different stage of her reign. Here, she became queen being in Africa when her father passed away. Very young and beautiful and very blessed. You can see that at the time she became queen, the kingdom was as powerful as ever, reigning, still having a big hand in America, in Australia, in Canada, in most of the part of Africa and all the islands. So the reign was untouched. And the globe, this globe, the globe of power, was still not half closed. But you can see how close was the globe. Now, from the time of a reign to the time of a marriage, you can see the different stage of her happiness and beauty, the phasing through time and reign. The same phenomena that was happening into her was also happening to the way of the power to the country, because through this time you can see the globe losing his power. Here, this turning point in the very center of her reign, the United Kingdom was still united. Because having a title like Queen of Canada or Queen of Australia is just a title of recognition of power, but really it's not like it used to be in that time. Because in the time of the 90s, the 80s, people who have been doing wrong thing in England have been sent to Australia. So it was really like a, not like a colonization, but worse than colonization. Because in colonization time, you make the colonized person look like you. You change his language, you change the way he think, the way he dress. Because if you look at all the British colony, they have been looking like the British. The way they dress, the English, the language, and in all, in most of the area of life, the organization of the society, it was looking just like in the mainland England. But from the reign of the Queen to this level, almost 50 years into her reign, the United Kingdom power was remaining just in the United Kingdom. This is until the Jubilee. Now, after the conspiracy of not joining the second wave of the German domination, because we need to understand, for those who think Europe is united because it's called Europe and they're acting almost together, but within Europe there is a very deep division when it comes to power. Because the German, after the First and the Second World War, they lost, of course, but not in the mind. They never changed their mind. People, the Europeans, have tried to oppress the sense of domination on other countries of Europe. But the Germans, they never lost their mind. Because you can see the daughter of Hitler manipulating the French, and she come back in such a power that the British did not want to go back under the German domination. Because today, the German, they're pushing the French like this: go over there, go over there, go back in Africa, you speak in the name of the Europe. Because the German themselves, they cannot take the front line to show that they are back in the world power. So when the British saw that the German, they're coming back again, so they start digging into their own sovereignty and their own freedom, saying they don't, because they don't want to surrender to Europe. In fact, they don't want to surrender to the German like the French. Because the French today, by themselves, cannot do anything in this world, because the world has changed so much, and Europe is becoming like a drop of water in the sea. So, is an obligation for Europe to be united if they want to have a voice in the world tomorrow. So, the aim of the German in the First World War and Second World War is happening today. They are the power force of Europe today. And they are the ones who are directing, after taking control of the 25 or 26 countries of Europe who are under their scheme, including France, because France is going shouting in all countries because of the German. They're counting on the Germans, so they're doing those things. So the British didn't want to give up the authority and everything they have done to the German, which is makes sense. But every everything has a time. And time himself is truth, is freedom, is life. So, moving from 2012, where that conspiracy and the power of the German was growing so strongly, to this reign, into this reign, the British flag, who has been all over the world, all over the United Kingdom, is just in a few small places. Today, we're still in the middle of the separation between the European and the Britain, and the British. Today, they're still talking of how to control the sea, the this and that, the negotiations are still on because the Brexit is not completely finished. But in the same time, into the kingdom, every part of the United Kingdom is taking control of its own country. In Wales, the Prime Minister is taking control of the country. The Scottish are taking control of the country. So, the United Kingdom is breaking down. Every country is gaining its independence into the United Kingdom. Meaning, from now on, we cannot speak of United Kingdom anymore. We're speaking of England. It's not official yet, but today we're speaking of England. When it comes to decision or thing can be coordinated, but you can see the differences how every single prime minister is taking control of his own people and his own land and making decisions who are a bit coordinated, who are good, but who are different. And that will carry on in most of the decision concerning each country. Why? Because of the Brexit. Because of the time. And because of the honor of the world. In fact, the example set by using the British Empire, one of the greatest in recent time, helped me or brighten my understanding to what happened to Rome, to what happened to Egypt, to what is happening to most of the places who are taking for granted the opportunity to help or to rise. And the same system, time, that is operating all over our globe. It does not exist because there is no time. You can change it like you want. It's invisible. So in reality, time is the creator. In time, everything is revealed. In time, every life is cool. In time, every greatness, every pride come to an end. But we human still cannot grasp the power set in our universe. At this specific moment, I'm talking, so many countries are rising in wealth. So many places are developed. this very day, the greatest country in our planet is China. And we can see the effect of the power all over the earth. Starting with COVID, the good, the money, the putting all over the places, and the system of oppression they started exercising in Africa and other parts of the world by almost wiping away all the assets and the good of the country, buying most of the places and all those things. Today, our world should be using the example of the United Kingdom, who is still speaking of the greatness. They're still dreaming. Every single thing, if you watch the news here, every single thing is the greatest this, the world first this, the world first this, the greatest country, the greatest city. So the pride is thick in the mouth, but the reality is not found on the ground. Look at the Middle East. One country is rising here and dropping bomb to the neighbor. Look in Africa. Most of the weapons which are no use in the Middle East are now found in all those small countries in Africa, creating more chaos than ever in the time where every country is trying to develop, every country is trying to make the world be a better place by oppressing the rest of the population and making a few people being billionaire, something that will never work. We should use the time and the example of those who in the past were thinking by taking everything from other country, they can enjoy those things. We should use that example of the European, for more than one century have been spending the time gathering wealth from Africa, from India, from America, from all those countries to come back in Europe, build fortress and enjoy the bounty while other people are dying. But today, when you look at the world, if you are a newborn child and they show you the map of the world, never you said Europe was a developed place. Never! Because the pride is just in the media. If you go in Asia, you see life, you see the development, even in Africa. And you come back here, you said, but those people have been so selfish. The Belgian king, Leopold II, have been cutting hand of the African in Africa just because he wanted them to work for him. Look at the World War I and World War II. So many loss of life just for the control, just for the power. And everything today is coming to an end. Look at the oppression of the Indian. Today, Indian is a country and everyone is trying to get well with another. Every country, everything is global. Our world today is becoming something that we do not match according to our mind. We are having something like 200 years behind the evolution of our technology. Human remain the same to the one of the Neanderthal, the Homo sapiens, the Homo habilis, the savage. In the time of the first aboriginal, half human, half animal, like they said. We live in the modern time with the same mind. Just look around us. From here, I can buy something in China. I can send something in Africa. I can call somebody in America. I can vote for Trump. But human cannot travel from one place to another. Humans are still starving in some countries. Something that does not happen to other living creatures on earth. Look at in Yemen. Look at in Palestine. The horror we have been living in South Africa with the apartheid. The killing, the humiliation of humanity. We're still sharing the same mind, having the same thinking, not willing to change, while everything around us has changed. Every human can lay his hand in any computer, the computer will never refuse to work because of his color or his country. No human is proud to be a human. If you see a proud human, he will be proud of something. He will be proud of his country. He will be proud of his car. He will be proud of his clothes. He will be proud of his house. He will be proud of his color maybe, but he will never going to be proud to be a human. As human, we are not proud to be a human. Human don't take pride to be a human because we're still killing each other, because we're still oppressing each other, because we're still bringing some other down while we want to be on top. But if we use this example where somebody can control half of the world and end up unable to control even his own kingdom, while his own kingdom is splitting in front of his eyes, but it does not have any control, any say, and anything to change to what is happening. And that has happened to Rome. And it will always happen to those who are taking their own self to make themselves more higher than time. Because time is the answer of everything. Thank you.